myself Balasubramanyam, assistant professor in EC department, St. Martin Engineering College. Right. In my presentation is about introduction to analog and digital communications. So before going to start our session, I just want to give a brief introduction to the communication system. First of all, what is meant by communication? So communication is nothing but exchanging the information between one point to another point, or from source to destination. For example, I am the information source and I am delivering the information to the destination. So this is the actual definition for the communication system. The basic block diagram of communication system is like this. So basically it consists of three parts. First one is the transmitter. Channel receiver. So transmitter section is at source point and receiver section at destination point. So in the channel there may be a chances of interference, noise, distortion. Right. So actually, for example, if I want to communicate with a group of people which are I just deliver my talk easily, but if I want to communicate with the a group of people in a seminar hall, then in that condition I need to use the amplifier section. But in a case, if I want to deliver it something, I want to transfer some message to the a person who is longer distances from me, in that cases I need to use the these type of structures. So basic communication system consists of, first of all, a source of information source. For example, here my voice is the message, and that message to be transferred into the longer distances, that is for into the destination. So for that, first of all, my voice is need to convert it into the electrical signal. So that process is performed by the transducer. So example, voice communication, that is voice signal is to be communicated into the electrical signal. This can be obtained by the microphone. So this output of the microphone is an electrical signal, and that will be given to the transmitter. So the transmitter will perform the whatever the things required to transmit the this message signal to the destination without any distortions and without any loss of the signal. For that it performs some functionalities like amplification, second thing, modulation, and third one is in some cases coding. So these are the, and so on, etc. So these are the some basic functionalities performed by the transmitter. So after performing these things, this transmitter emits the signal into the channel. So here the channel may be of two types, that is either wired or wireless. So example for wired communication is telephone communication. Example for wireless communication is mobile communication, which we are using. So in the channel, depending on the channel, there may be a chances of interference, distortions and noise. So we need to avoid these things by using different techniques. So after that, by transmitting through the channel, this signal reaches the destination part by means of a receiver. So receiver is the thing which performs the reverse process of the transmitter. So here the functionalities of the receiver are amplification, and demodulation, and third one, decoding. So these are the some functionalities performed by the receiver section
to reproduce the actual message signal. So the output of the receiver signal is a electrical signal. So there I transmitted a voice signal, but here we need to produce a voice signal. For that, the output of the receiver is given to the one more transducer, which converts the electrical signal into the voice signal, that is a speaker. So in this manner, a message is converted into electrical signal, and electrical signal is by making some processes. After the process emits into the channel, after that a receiver section receives that message and reproduces and given to the destination part. So this is the actual block diagram of a basic communication system. So here we are having a very important topic here, which is called as modulation. So my next topic is modulation. So here, before going to define modulation, I want to give some clarity on the signals involving in this modulation process. So here in the modulation process, there are three signals involved. First is a message signal, which is also called as modulating signal. And second one is a carrier signal, and third one is a modulated signal. So first one is the message signal or modulating signal. So this is the signal which consists of the message to be transferred. So next thing is the carrier signal. Carrier signal is nothing but a high frequency MD signal, which is used to transmit this signal over longer distances. And this modulated signal is the actual outcome of the modulation process. So these are the three signals involved in the modulation process. So coming to the definition of the modulation is the process of changing the characteristics of carrier signal with respect to the instantaneous values of the message signal. Once again, I am repeating, modulation is the process of changing some characteristics of carrier signal with respect to the message signal, that is instantaneous values of the message signal. Here the properties of carrier signals are either it may be amplitude or frequency, phase. Okay, so what are the different modulation techniques are there? Before going to discuss about it, what is the need of modulation? So need of modulation is whatever the message signal, for example my voice signal or something, so that message signal is incompatible to travel longer distances. So we need to because of its lower strength, so we need to make it as a strengthened signal by using a carrier signal. So this process is called as the modulation. So for transmitting the message signal over longer distance, we need to compulsory perform the modulation. So the advantage of modulation is we can reduce the antenna size is reduced. After that, so we can implement the multiplexing process. So we can improve the bandwidth. Improved bandwidth. And improved reception rate. So these are the advantages of the modulation process. So let us coming to the different types of modulation techniques. So modulation, first of all, basically it is classified into two types. First one is the continuous wave modulation, and second one is the pulse wave modulation, or simply pulse modulation techniques. So coming to the continuous wave modulation, further it is classified into amplitude modulation, and second one, angle modulation. Further, this angle modulation is classified into frequency modulation and phase modulation. Phase modulation. So these are the continuous wave type of modulation techniques. Coming to the pulse wave modulation techniques, depending on the type of message, for example, if the message is analog, then it is analog type of pulse wave, and if it is message is a digital form, then it is a digital type of pulse modulation technique. So in analog type of can be classified into pulse amplitude modulation, pulse width modulation, pulse position modulation. So coming to the digital type of modulations, it comes pulse code and modulation, and some ASK, PSK, and so on. In some cases, example delta modulation also. So these are the different types of modulation techniques. Okay. So first of all, what is meant by continuous wave modulation? So continuous wave modulation is the technique in which a carrier wave is a sinusoidal and it is a continuous wave. Whereas coming to the pulse wave, here in this modulation technique, we use a carrier signal which is a train of pulses, rectangular pulses. Okay. So coming to here, first one, amplitude modulation. So this is the modulation technique in which the amplitude of the carrier signal varies with respect to the instantaneous values of the message signal. That's why it is called as the amplitude modulation. Coming to the frequency modulation, this is the modulation technique in which the frequency of the carrier signal varies with the instantaneous values of the message signal. In the same manner, phase modulation also. That is, the phase of the carrier signal will change with respect to the message signal. So these are the different modulation techniques which are involved in the continuous wave modulation. So next one is the pulse wave modulation. So pulse wave modulation, here we are using a carrier as train of pulses as carrier. So if message signal is in analog, for example, depending on the message signal amplitude or something, values of message signal, if the pulse amplitude is changing, for example, here I am using a pulses, train of pulses. So depending on this message value, this pulse amplitude also changes. Then that type of modulation technique is called as pulse amplitude modulation method. If this pulse width is changes with respect to the message signal, then that type of modulation is called as pulse width modulation. If pulse position, so that is frequency, changes, then that particular type of modulation technique is called as pulse position modulation. So coming to the digital process, this message signal, if this message signal is analog in nature, then that message signal is converted into digital form, that is binary values, that is 0 or 1, zeros and ones. So that zeros and ones, and with the pulse signals, we perform a modulation techniques example for that is a pulse coded modulation techniques. So these are the different types of modulation techniques. In this, I am going to explain amplitude modulation technique.